Therefore, since we are justified by faith, we have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ, through whom we have obtained access to this grace in which we stand, and we boast in our hope of sharing the glory of God. And not only that, but we also boast in our sufferings, knowing that suffering produces endurance. Endurance produces character. Character produces hope. And hope does not disappoint us because God's love has been poured into our hearts through the Holy Spirit that has been given to us. Chapter 5 of Paul's letter to the church in Rome. You know, sometimes you read scripture in the Bible, especially in the New Testament, and it can really sound like the writer is writing to someone in our current situation. And it's actually true. Oftentimes, the writers are writing to fellow Christians who are enduring persecution during difficult times, or the diaspora, they're in exile, they have to flee, or physical stress. The letters of Scripture from Paul and Peter and John were almost actually written for people in our situation to comfort, to bolster up. So read the Bible like that, because it's for people who are under duress and stress, who need hope, who need Jesus. I love what Paul says here, because he points people, understandably, he knows that there's suffering going on for the Christians in Rome. And it's not like he's not sympathetic to it. Paul knows what suffering feels like. And it's not great, and it's not awesome. I don't want to pretend that it is. But Paul says there's opportunity for times like these, whether it's persecution or whether it's what we're going through right now, there's opportunity that God uses this to make us stronger in the faith. This is practical stuff, quite frankly, not necessarily Christian, right? I love how he says that we boast in our hope, we boast in our sufferings, knowing, we know this, that suffering produces endurance. Hardships cause and increase the ability to deal with stuff and keep on going forward. And that is a beautiful quality that you should want. Endurance produces character, right? It gives you integrity. You're not just a wishy-washy person that just kind of comes and goes with the times, but it sort of like pounds that carbon, makes that diamond. Endurance produces character. Character produces hope. We have this character, we can look at challenges and not give up because we have hope. And when you go through tough times, you actually learn to be hopeful. You learn to be hopeful. You learn to not be satisfied with the day, but always looking forward. You learn to cling to promises God has given us that He will simply take care of us, that He'll get through this virus, but also the promises of resurrection, of forgiveness. Tough times produce hope and help refine that hope and help us cling to that hope and be people of hope, not just now, but when this epidemic is over, and it will be. We want to keep on being those people of hope to people who are living in their own local epidemics. And finally, Paul says, hope does not disappoint us because God's love has been poured into our hearts through the Holy Spirit that has been given to us. And he goes on, verse 6, for while we were still weak, at the right time, Christ died for the ungodly. While we were still sinners, he says later, Jesus died for us. We have real hope. We have real hope that God provides because he has, time and time again. We have real hope that there is always a future in Jesus. There's always hope in Christ. He has conquered sin. He died for us. That's a fact. Left blood on the cross in your name. And he rose from the dead. We never, never, never stop hoping because we've been given everything in Jesus, because we're loved by God and we've seen him come through time and time again. May you have that hope, and may these times, though they are hard and they upset us, and they should, may they refine your faith, refine your hope, and through these times, may we be a light to the city, to people that don't have hope, never did, quite frankly. May this be a time that Jesus really shines in the loving care of a church, let alone a church that cares for their body and their soul. In Jesus' name.
I can't believe the news today. Oh, I can close my eyes and make it.